for tonight. Enjoy the show.
Well, met, fellow travellers, lend me your ear. A story of wonder you're going to hear. A story of magic and castles of old, of damsels and dragons and knights so bold. The Britons are strong and there's peace through the land under the might of King Arthur's hand. But wait, good people, listen ye well. A tale of terrible treason I tell. The year 531, the dawn is breaking, the day has begun. So let me begin to unravel my plot as I welcome you all to Camelot!
Rejoices on this day of celebration.
As we join with every Briton in the land to wish you a happy birthday.
birthday!
Happy birthday!
Thank you, my noble lords. And as is customary on my birthday, tonight, at my royal banquet, I shall make one squire an honorary knight to sit at my round table.
Don't forget about your daughters, dear. Remember, this morning you must go upon each of them the royal pendant to mark the end of their royal training.
Thank you, Guinevere, my dear. Now, where are my knights?
Presenting the leader of the knights with his booming voice that can be heard for miles!
Surround sound!
Thank you, sire. The knights of the round table would like to offer their greetings on this very special day. Firstly, the inventor of the round table, Sir Comfrey!
Royal felicitations, your royal highness.
Our secret service special agents, Surveillance and Security. Happy birthday, sire.
Many happy returns.
Our faithful, if a little scared and cowardly, surrender!
Hello.
Of course, our noble knights, Sir Ten, Sir Price, Sir Cus, and Sir Vide.
Who is a What have you got?
Scones.
Scones?
Is that it? It's not going to be much of a banquet.
Scones is all I can make, so scones is all there is.
Come on then, let's have some.
Very well, but just one.
RJ, my Johnny Jester. Good morning.
Is it? All ready for your cabaret spot tonight? Try that joke we gave you.
It's very funny, Mrs. Wobblers.
Cobblers!
Well, at least you're at first.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Arthur.
Arthur who?
Arthur. King Arthur.
You know the joke with the crown.
No,
it's Arthur. Arthur who? Arthur, any more scones left?
Apparently not. I've never heard such a terrible joke in all my life.
Lie! Don't talk to me about life.
Oh dear.
Every morning I wake up and think,
what's the point of it all?
Here we go again.
I spend all day bringing happiness to others and go to bed even more depressed than when I woke up. And tomorrow's going to be even worse.
Well, at least you don't let it get you down.
That's just it. This jolly personality is just a facade, a mask of merriment hiding my inner gloom and desolation.
Really?
My heart may be breaking, my soul may be crying out in the darkness, but on the outside I'm smiling and laughing, bringing joy and happiness to everyone around me.
Yes, so we see.
It isn't easy being so cheerful all the time. You know, it's just the talent I was born with.
Yes, well, I'm a little busy right now, but thank you for brightening up my morning.
Don't mention it!
There you are, what? How's my birthday boy? Having a good day, are we?
Having a good day? Have you forgotten what happened yesterday in night school? It was a total disaster!
Cheer up, what? It could have been worse.
It could have been worse? Mum, I was expelled!
Yeah, you're right. It was a total disaster.
I still don't understand. Tell me again, how did it happen?
Well, it was just like any other day at night school.
Right. Pay attention, young squires. Tomorrow is King Arthur's birthday, and one of you may be chosen to become a knight in the birthday honours list. So, here's your chance to impress me. We're going to start by reciting the Knight's Code. I hope you all have learnt it off by heart.
Yes, Sir Laxminster.
Good. Then we shall begin.
A knight is good and well behaved. A knight is neat and cleanly shaped. A knight is right and never wrong. He's clever and his feet don't fall.
Sorry, I'm late, Sir Laxminster.
What problems? You should have been here half an hour ago.
Why? What happened?
You're 11 years old tomorrow, Watts, and yet you seem to have learned nothing.
He'll never be a knight in shining armour, will he, Alex Minster?
Yeah, more like a knit in shining armour.
He's not the brightest bulb in the pack, is he?
Hey, what? You know why you're so dim? Because you're only 10, what?
That's enough, boys! What? This is your last chance. Say the knight's oath.
That's easy, Alex Minster. I'll be a good knight.
You missed the last word.
What comes after good night?
Sleep tight.
No! Always! I swear to be a good knight always.
Oh, right. I'll be a good knight always.
No, it's an oath. You must swear it.
I'll be a good knight always, bumface.
What cobblers? I have had enough. My name is Erlax Minster and you can't walk all over me. I never want to see you here again. Henceforth, you are expelled.
Bet on it.
Just do exactly what I say, and you'll be fine.
an extremely important object, and with no apprentice, I'll have to search on my own.
I thought you just hired two new assistants.
Those blackhead brats were nothing but trouble. Only lost a week, and now they've run off and stolen their magic mirror.
And now you need an apprentice? I know, just the person.
What?
That's right. Gosh, you really are a good magician.
Well, that's marvellous, but you'll have to excuse me. I must keep searching while King Arthur will.
Oh dear, I hate to think what King Arthur will do.
They could see I'm turning each page I saw.
Our story turns a page, but quite a different castle forms the setting of our stage. Rook Castle, dark and dingy, not a place of love or light. It's home to evil plotting and our villain, the Black Knight.
Halt, strangers!
Who goes there?
Identify yourself.
Ernie and Bernie Blackhead.
The Black Knight's most trusted henchman.
Very good.
You may pass.
Right, Bernie. There he is. You tell him.
He's playing chess, Ernie. You go tell him.
You go tell him.
But he hates being interrupted when he's playing chess. You go tell him.
You go tell him.
You tell him.
You tell him.
You tell him.
You tell me. Tell him.
Ah!
My lord, we have returned triumphant. May I present Merlin's Mirror.
Ernie and Bernie Blackhead, my trusty henchmen. For once you have done something, right? Merlin's wonderful mirror is mine.
Let's try it. Wow, this is hilarious. I love these silly mirrors. Ernie, come look at my weird wonky face.
It's not a silly mirror. It's a magic mirror. It can do magic.
Cool. Can it make me good looking and intelligent?
I said it can do magic.
I got arrested for that last year.
Now, good work. Read instructions.
Congratulations on purchasing the marvelous magic mirror. This latest breakthrough magical household object should give you many years of trouble-free fortune telling. To operate, rub the face 3 times.
Right, here goes.
Not me. Pull the face of the mirror. Here, leave it to me.
Thank you. your name?
Yes.
Yes?
That's a strange name.
No, you don't understand. What's my name?
You mean you don't know? Gosh, what sort of fools are they sending me these days?
Now please, try to concentrate and tell me your name.
What?
Tell me your name.
What is my name?
I don't know.
No,
I have to have your full name so I can write it on this form.
What? Cobblers!
No, it's true. Look, wait a minute. What cobblers? Any relation to Mrs. Cobblers, the cook?
Yes, that's my mum.
I see. What cobblers? Well, I'm glad we've got that sorted out. Now, let's see if your magic is up to scratch. Where did I put my wand?
It's behind you, Mr. Merlin, sir.
Ah, so it is. Just hold it for me while I get the spell book.
What have you done to my wand?
Give it here. There, that's better. Now take it, and this time please be careful.
Yes, sir.
No, 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 give it here, you useless boy.
I am trying.
Yes, you certainly are, but not to worry. With a teacher like me, you'll soon be smelling the roses of success. You'll like this, not a lot, but you'll like it. Abracadabra.
Wow.
Now, here's a simple job you can get started with. Label my magic potion bottles for me. These are strength potions, and these are animal potions. Don't get the labels mixed up. I've got to carry on searching.
Simpson, help! Now,
where's the glue?
Ah! Ah! The dragon! Get back, you monster!
Oh, what? You tickle me to death? Don't make me laugh.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Are you alright?
Well, yes, I think so.
I'm not talking to you. Dusty,
are you alright? Did he hurt you?
Miss Alice, thank goodness you're here.
My name may be Dusty, but I don't need a feather duster up my hooter.
Princess Alice! Do you know this dragon?
Of course I do. He's my best friend, aren't you, Dusty?
Certainly, Miss Alice.
Now, let me at it! Let me at it!
Bite you right on the...
But we don't bite our friends, do we, Dusty?
And what is our friend?
But no marks!
Yeah, especially not mine.
Princess Alice, how do you know my name?
Everyone knows what cobblers. Only Squire to get expelled from night school.
Yeah, I bet I'm the biggest joke in Camelot.
I think that was pretty cool, actually. I like people who break the rules, as you can see. If my father knew I was keeping a dragon in the castle, he'd ground me for life.
Ground you? You're the biggest hero in Camelot. You know, Miss Alice found me in the forest before I'd even hatched. I was an orphan. I was very shy and quiet back then, but I soon came out of my shell.
Oh no, I've dropped the labels. What a muddle. I'd better get them stuck back in quickly before Merlin gets back.
Here, we'll help, won't we, Dusty?
Sure.
Princess Alice! Princess Alice, I thought we agreed to keep Dusty a secret if your father finds out.
Don't worry, what's a member of the gang now?
What's the matter, Merlin? You've been acting strange for a while.
Oh, Princess Alice, I'm in serious trouble.
What sort of trouble?
You see, King Arthur thought the Black Knight might try to steal Excalibur, so he asked me to protect and hide it, and I thought of the most marvellous idea.
Yes?
I used a magic spell to shrink Excalibur until it was tiny.
Yes?
Then I was able to hide it somewhere safe.
Yes?
Somewhere no one would ever find it.
Yes?
And now I can't find it.
You lost Excalibur!
For heaven's sake, what? Be quiet!
But if the Black Knight gets hold of it, he'll be the new king!
I know. I've been searching for days without success. Oh, King Arthur finds out.
Well, he won't, because we're going to help you find it. Right, boys?
Right. Marvellous. You have a hunt around here. I'll take the strength potions to King Arthur. He asked them to be on standby today, just in case. Good luck.
Looks like I'm not the only one who gets into trouble around here.
Yes, I suppose we are a bit different, aren't we?
I hate being different. People either stare at me or try to skewer me with a feather duster.
All right, I'm sorry about
out the feather duster.
Mics, please.
The big ticket isn't that bad, Dusty. I should know. And you, well, you're one of a kind.
Thank you.
excuse to attack. But if we all stay alert, we can make sure nothing terrible happens.
Something terrible's happened!
What?
The princesses! They've gone!
Gone?
What do you mean gone?
They've been kidnapped!
Kidnapped?
Is there an echo in here?
It was the evil Blackhead brothers. Look, the dirty rascal left a ransom note stating their demands.
2 pints of milk and a string of sausages.
Oh, sorry, that's my shopping list.
Bring me the sword Excalibur, or you'll never see your daughters again. Signed, the soon-to-be king, the Black Knight.
That's terrible!
A catastrophic disaster!
Disaster!
It's all so depressing! Oh, my poor little ducklings. Whatever shall we do, dear?
They'll never get their hands on that sword. Merlin, is Excalibur safe? Is it hidden where no one can find it?
Yes, you could say that.
Excellent. Is your new strength potion ready?
All cocked up and ready to drink, sire.
Then there's only one thing for it. We must rescue the princesses. Knights, are you ready for the most important quest of your lives?
We are ready, sire.
I have a cunning plan already prepared.
We'll capture the evil blackhead brothers.
And then we'll squeeze those evil blackheads for information.
Then, like dashing heroes, rescue the princesses and return triumphant.
If we ever do return...
Don't be such a defeatist, Miranda.
Yes, you can do it.
That's right, young squires, let's hear it for the Knights of Camelot!
Shattered if she saw me now.
Which is what you're being. Don't behave.
Excalibur 2 will be there soon. But be warned, Merlin has magically disguised his appearance to protect it. Good old Merlin. Now he knew how to treat the mirror properly.
That sneaky sorcerer will never fool me. And will I get my hands on that sword?
Excalibur will be in the palm of your hand this very day.
In the palm of my hand, you see, life is like a game of chess. Every move meticulously planned as I take my opponent's pieces, one by one. Soon, the white king will surrender and I shall end the game victorious.
Blimey, he really is chess mad, isn't he?
I know, we had a Czech tablecloth for dinner last night. It took him 2 hours to pass the soul.
Now, I jumped for my two favourite sports.
He's calling us prawns again, Ernie. He's gone prawn crackers.
Don't be cheeky. My guards will stop those snacks from getting very far. You two must wait until the Excalibur is revealed, then seize it and keep it safe for me. Remember, Merlin has disguised it, so keep your wits about you, if you have any. Then I shall have everything I want, Camelot, Excalibur, and the crown! Ah, ah,
ah! I don't want to be a prawn anymore, Ernie. Why can't he be a prawn for a change?
He's just selfish.
And what if one of those knights comes after us, eh?
Look, if the knight comes our way, I'll distract them and you creep up behind them with your big club and then voila, you club them in the head.
That's brilliant, Ernie!
Why?
Because I love going night clubbing!
got powder jump. You have managed to take a potion. I think we should take it. Now, here.
What are you two doing?
Haven't you read the label?
It says shake vigorously before drinking. Just drink it.
Ooh. I have a bad feeling about this.
All together, ready? One, two, three.
It's all right, Princess Alice. Let's get okay. Whatever you do, don't drink that potion. You'll turn into animals.
Thank you.
He's a hero.
Hey, stop it!
You're making me go red.
Well, I think he'd make an excellent addition to the Royal Guard.
Agreed. Well, everything's turned out well. The princesses and Excalibur are safe.
Ah, yes. Well, Excalibur might not be so safe, Simon.
Merlin, what do you mean?
It's lost!
Thank you.
Good evening to everybody at home. I'm not sure if I am on camera. I'll just stand here and wave and say hi. What an absolute treat, Year 6. Sometimes you think you get to know people over the course of a few years, but what I've learned about you this evening, and the way that you've entertained, the way you've put your heart and soul into everything that you've done, I'll never look at you in the same way again. And I mean that in the very best way, but it's such a wonderful performance. And I feel so privileged to have been able to see that tonight. It has been the most amazing experience. Let's give you a massive round of applause. The play would have everything, and it did have everything. Jesters with an existential dilemma, wonderful princesses, hunky knights, evil people, good people, loving people, a sarcastic mirror, wonderful. It really did have an amazing breadth and range of performance. I'm so deeply impressed. But we all know that something like this doesn't just happen. It doesn't just happen one day and then suddenly we've got a performance. It does actually happen over the course of 8 days, I think, Mrs. Parker?
Seven
working days, which is absolutely unbelievable. But it does also rely on a huge number of people really giving of themselves, really giving of their time, giving of their experience, and making something like this wonderfully come together. So I've got a few thank yous to do, and I could use some help from maybe it's fine. Very useful. So, first of all, I would just like to say a huge thank you to the Year 6 teachers, to all of the staff who have been involved in all of the workshops, to all of the staff who have given up their time tonight doing makeup, doing hair, some fantastic bits of makeup, and lots of different bits of people have put into making this happen. But also, over the course of 2 weeks, running all of the workshops, helping all of you build your scrapbooks and doing the most amazing things. So can we give all of the colleagues who have helped a really big round of applause? Very much indeed to all of you, but we've got a few special thank yous to do as well. Where's Karen? Are you here? Karen Molden? Karen! Karen has actually all of the amazing outfits that you see here and has added such a professional level to the quality of the performance tonight. I know you guys have really enjoyed getting all of your outfits, and I've seen you all. And the huge amount of work that goes into not just this, but then curating and looking after and making sure that we've got everything that we need. So we're very grateful, Karen. Thank you very much indeed. There we go. So, Mrs. Lamar, would you like to come up as well, please? You were responsible for some of our choreography of One of a Kind. Can you show me the moves? No, don't. And thank you so much for working with the children, and we know that they've really enjoyed it and they've loved having your input, so let's say a big thank you very much. Where at the back of the hall we've got Mr. John Davis, who is over there. He has been responsible for all the technical side of things that you've seen happening tonight. Again, really adding to the professional quality of that performance. It has amazed me what's happened here this evening in terms of adding to the performance all of the bits and pieces that people perhaps haven't even thought about throughout the performance, but we're incredibly grateful for your time and the dedication you've given to this performance. Let's give you a big round of applause. I have been so thrilled with the dancing that's been going on this evening, but I'm not the only one. You have all been thrilled with the dancing that you've been doing. I think it was 2 days in when I saw you practicing in the hall, and you had nailed one of the numbers already. Absolutely amazing. And you've really risen to that challenge. It's really, really hard. I know I would have been crossing over and falling over, but you guys have been absolutely amazing. But thank you so much for leading us through that. It's really made the performance. I'm very, very grateful for your time and all of your expertise. So thank you very much. Hoping that all of you at home could join us for this evening, to knowing that we were going to broadcast this live. And then we have to then rely on the expertise of the team of people here at school, headed up by Charlotte Groves. And Charlotte has been absolutely amazing stepping into that space, not just doing something simply, but we've got lots of different cameras around, I'm not sure which one I should be looking at, but making that experience for you at home is not a straightforward task, but Charlotte's given off her time and her expertise, and we are so incredibly grateful. Charlotte, we'd like to give you a big round of applause. Thank you. Would you like to come up and join us? I know that you've lived and breathed this, not just for the 2 weeks that we've been doing the rehearsals, but weeks and weeks in advance as you've been planning everything. I still remember that conversation where you sat in my office, you said, it's going to be amazing. And you undersold it.
It was
doubly amazing. You absolutely undersold it. But thank you for leading us all the way through that process, not just tonight, but everything that's happened in the meantime. They've had the most fantastic time. We've had the most fantastic time. I hope now that you can relax and breathe. But it's been absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much indeed.
Thank you, guys.
Last thank you absolutely has to go to you lot. I'm so deeply impressed with what you've managed to do over the course of a few days, with the passion with which you've given your all to this project, and the performance has been absolutely outstanding. Everything from the scenery that you've done to the props, everything from the acting, the dancing, the singing, you've thrown yourself into it and given us the most magical experience and wonderful memories that we'll treasure forever. So let's give you the biggest and final round of applause. Well done, Ian. We're going to sign off now so that you can get in your cars and come and collect your children. We've got to squeeze in some makeup taking off and a party before you get here as well. So we're going to get moving. Thank you very much for joining us tonight. Thank you to the audience in the hall as well. Well done, Year 6.